Your money could be set to go further, with more New Zealand companies having a large stockpile of goods. What was a supply chain crisis during the pandemic is now an inventory crisis, with money tied up in products just sitting on the shelf. New data shows Kiwi companies are holding twice the value of stock compared to pre-pandemic levels, from $360 million in late 2019 to nearly $800 million worth now. And the inventory that's on the shelf is a third less profitable, the return on investment on Kiwi goods dropping from 1.8% before COVID to 1.2%. Manufacturers are paying nearly 10% more for their goods than they were at the start of the year. Sport and entertainment and rubber and plastics are the two industries with the biggest increase in stocks. For how businesses are managing these financial challenges and what it means for your buying power, here's business correspondent Katie Bradford.
The owners of this Kiwi business can't wait for product to start flying off these very full shelves and into the hands of consumers.
If we're comparing the last 12 months, our stock on hand has more than doubled.
After 2 years of supply chain problems and shipping delays, businesses are facing a new issue. Data from 4,500 manufacturers found stock doubling and margins dropping.
The impact is significant. So customers ultimately, or our customers, don't want to miss out on sales. So they're making sure that they have enough stock to fulfil those sales. So they've gone with the lesser evil to some degree by overstocking.
From empty shelves in 2021 to full shelves in 2022, it's called the bullwhip effect. A Massey University survey of businesses on supply chain risks highlighted the same issue.
Most of them are saying that inventory is the biggest issue on their radar. The warehouses are filling up. They're talking about putting stock in containers even, which can be quite expensive.
And it's now a cash flow problem.
We've had to go to our bank and increase our finance facility and definitely needed that extra bit of cash, especially coming over the summer months.
So I was talking to a bike manufacturer a couple of weeks ago. They had 90% of the components for the bikes in the warehouse, gathering dust, a lot of capital wrapped up in it. They were waiting on that last component that was coming out of a plant in Japan, and they can't sell any of that product until they get that.
The inventory crisis comes at the same time, of course, as a cost of living crisis. The cost of goods have increased by about 10% this year, and for those left with extra stock, of course, the question is, what do they do with it?
That looks like sales, discounts, great stuff for consumers, obviously, but for those businesses that are having to foot that bill, it's a real challenge.
Those who rely on parts from overseas, like microchips, hit the hardest.
So energy, chemicals, building, construction.
It's a guessing game to work out what's needed when.
Taking the approach of we'd rather have more than less and not run out.
At the same time, the market has dropped, and I think that is the most significant component of the inventory situation that we have at the moment, is we are going into a financial slowdown, and that is not going to stop.
2023 set to pose some new challenges.
Okay, Katie is with us now from the newsroom. Katie, put it into perspective for us. You mentioned in your story we've got a cost of living crisis, we're heading into a recession. Is there a risk of having no buyers for these products?
Kia ora, well, this is only the start of this problem, and there may be some lucky consumers, some lucky shoppers out there who will snap up a bargain. You may see businesses having to discount products because they're going to expire or they have no choice. But of course, as you heard in that story, that's not good for those businesses who are already struggling with these extra costs and extra problems. We are running at the start of this economic slowdown. If we go into recession next year, it won't be until we're heading towards the second half. These problems are just starting to pile up now. It is not a problem in New Zealand alone, though. This is a global issue. Of course, here in New Zealand, we are so impacted by what happens everywhere else and so dependent on those factors. And that will weigh on whether this problem continues to be as big as it looks to be right now or whether things start to ease off next year.
Ngā mihi nui. Thanks for the analysis. Thanks, Katie.